Today I'm doing a drawing tutorial on both Thor and Gore, the God Butcher. Okay, so whenever I'm drawing a person, today I am drawing Thor and the God Killer. God Butcher, sorry. But yeah, whenever I'm drawing a person, I usually start with the face, because it's just easier to, you know, to start with the face, for me at least. And I build off of it, and I do the surrounding body parts or surrounding images. And so with this, I started with a circle and kind of just did the outlines of the face right there. And from there, I go on to the adjacent body parts. With the arm, I start with the arm, and then I draw a circle for the hand. And then I go in from that circle and add the little lines for the fingers. The hand can be very challenging, so it's good to, you know, draw the arm first and then kind of just get, you know, understand the positioning of the hand. And then go in and add the little fingers, because I feel like that's the trickiest part. And from there, I go in and I do the shoulder, and this right here is the blade that's underneath his chest. So it's really his right arm that's coming down, but it's in the form of a blade, as you can see in the adjacent reference photo. And then I'm just going for general shapes, so I'm not necessarily trying to add any, you know, crazy detail. I'm just trying to outline the drawing and get an understanding of where everything is and how to position it. So it does take me a couple of times to get certain parts of the picture, but we're just trying to get the positioning down, and then afterwards we'll go in and add more detail. So I think I sped this up by like two or 300% or something like that. So there's a lot of moving parts in this picture. They take a while to do, but you know, once you have everything positioned, from there it's, you know, just going in and pretty much perfecting the little minor things, because the devil really is in the details when it comes to doing pictures like these. But now we are pretty much 90% through the outline of this character. I'd say one of the trickiest parts for me for doing this one was his left arm, because it's just kind of not even a hand at the end of it. It's just a bunch of little veins and whatever that black glue is that he has. So from here, I'm moving down towards his legs and his feet, and I'm just looking at what I've built on to pretty much determine how to position the rest of his body. So I'm looking at the reference photo, and I'm looking, okay, how far is the end of his foot from the end of his arm? How big or how wide is it compared to a body part? Where does it make contact? Where does the middle of his thigh make contact with that right kneecap right there? Okay. So from here, I'm moving further down into the picture, and I'm starting with Thor. And again, I'm starting with the head, because that's, you know, I like to build off of the head. It's just a good focal point to start your drawing when you're drawing people, because usually that's the first thing that the eyes shift to, is the head. And so if you have the head positioned right, then it's easy to just build everything from there, as far as positioning, proportions, all that stuff. So his helmet, there's his helmet that I'm doing, and looking at that back part of his waist, I can see that it doesn't go much further than the side of his helmet. So I keep the waist right at the side, and I'm, you know, that's just again using that helmet as a focal point to to see where I'm going to position other parts of the character's body. And Thor was a lot easier to draw than the God Butcher, because the detail wasn't as significant. So I, you know, just add his foot right there, and just adjusting the sides, his traps, his biceps right there. One part that did give me the hardest, a lot of difficulty to draw, surprisingly for me, was the hammer. And it was just pretty much positioning the angle that the slab of stone that is his hammer was. And so I did struggle on that a little bit. And, you know, for drawing really general shapes, so your drawings are going to be really loose. Your lines are going to be very loose, very flexible, because you're going to be making changes to it in the beginning. So now we're kind of doubling back and going in and filling that detail. So I'm again starting with the face and everything in that surrounding area. I'm just slowly adding detail. I'm going in, I'm adding the black veins to his arm. I'm going in and I'm fixing whatever, adding details to the shapes that I've, you know, because it's positioned now. So now you're just going in and filling in that detail and pretty much perfecting it, preparing it to get inked in, to get colored in. Something I didn't do that I probably should have is darken in those blacker areas, those darker areas, just scribbling in a little bit those sections with pencil. You know, so it would be, you know, his sword, his hood, that the little black area behind his body, and, you know, his left hand as well. For Thor would be the inside of his cape, and just so you can kind of see it better, because it's right now everything's just like an outline and it can be a little bit difficult. So if you're doing the strong, you could definitely go in and do that, fill in those areas with, just shade them in lightly with pencil. But again, you know, we're moving down to Thor, and started with his head, and then I'm kind of just moving downwards and adding in the details to his belt and to his armor, his legs and his armor. Because we're going to go in and add ink after this. And I had to ink this a little bit differently, because it's not like anime or just regular comics. The person that did this, as you can see, kind of painted it. So I don't do an outline in ink for this whole thing. I pretty much just fill in the dark areas, the black. And then from there, I build on with color, coloring in the rest of the piece. So, yeah, we are at the tricky part for me, which is the hammer. And I was actually surprised that this gave me so much trouble, but, you know, we're just filling in details. You have that general position that that you outlined earlier. So now you're just, and, you know, part of it too with me is I can be a perfectionist, and, you know, that's one thing I gave up on, because you can never really get it 100% perfect, okay? But now, you know, the picture's coming together. It would've been nice to have those darker areas filled in a little bit, but the picture's coming together, and now it's almost ready for, you know, some ink. So there you go, you got the picture, the general little outline, and now you can go in and fill it in. This part is pretty straightforward. You're just filling in the dark area. So what I'll do now is I think I'll just take this time to, you know, give you guys a little bit of background of, you know, who Gore is, because everybody knows who Thor is, come on, Thor. But Gore is he was this being, this guy who was on a planet, a very destitute, very dry planet, and basically his people were on the verge of just extinction. So he's traveling through this vast desert, and he goes through tragedy. I don't really want to spoil it too much for you guys, but he goes through tragedy, and his people are very religious. You know, they look to the gods for guidance, and so they pray to the gods to offer sacrifices. But you know, their people suffer, and so Gore becomes very angry at the gods. And he honestly doesn't even think they exist after a while, because if they did, why wouldn't they come and help him? And so he ends up getting powers and goes on this crusade against the gods. And as we know, Thor is a god. So where were you, Thor, when my people were suffering, is kind of his thought process. It's a really good story. I don't want to give away too much spoilers, but if you guys want to check out the comic book yourself, it's Thor, God of Thunder, and then the second part is the first part is Thor, God of Thunder, the God Butcher, and then the second book is Thor, God of Thunder, God Bomb. So you can go check those out on Amazon if you guys want something like that. From a local bookstore. So now I'm getting into the coloring, and the first part where his sword connects to his flesh, that's pretty much just me using a cool gray to blend into the white, and for his skin I used a jade green with the Prisma color markers, and that's really just a really light grayish kind of green looking green. I don't have the exact colors in the reference photo, so I always just ballpark it. And for the darker areas, I use the light, I think it's 108 gray, it's like a cool gray, to go over the darker areas in his skin, so you can see like little shadows in between the fibers of his muscle. And that's just a darker cool gray that he used to highlight those shadows out. And those were like the three base colors, you know. And I did go in with pencil to get the details, because it's kind of hard to get the really fine points with just markers. So the little finer shadows, I went in and used the pencil to push it, accentuate those, pull those out a little bit. And for his foot, I used like a cotton pearl kind of beige, and a light brown for his toenails, I guess, and I blended that in with the jade green. For Thor's skin, I used a light kind of beigeish color, and I went in with a darker one to do his shadows, because his skin isn't as alien as Gore. So you're just pretty much using regular skin tone colors, and to for the shadows, I used again a light grayish color to do the shadows throughout his arms. And I did go in again with pencil, and a little bit later on I went in with pencil to do the veins and stuff in his arm. I did also use a color pencil right there, a little light gray color pencil, to just get those fine details for the shadows. So far, we used a light skin tone, a darker skin tone, and then we went over the shadow areas with a lighter gray to accentuate the shadows. And now you can see I'm using the pencil, like I said before, to just get, you know, the little veins, the little lines in his arms, the little muscle fibers that are in his arm. And I'm lighting anywhere that I feel like is a bit too dark. I went in with the white color pencil to smoothing it out to blend it in with the colors a little bit. And you know, for the shadow on his face, I actually used like a purple and light gray for that shadow area. And for the blood on his face, that was a raspberry red kind of color. Now the helmet is different layers of gray. Start off with a light gray, and the medium gray, and black for the darkest areas of the helmet. And I did use color pencil to go in and add that medium tone, and then I just pretty much went over the whole thing with light gray right there. So black, medium, and light gray. Color pencil and marker. So the hair, pretty easy, it's only two colors. I'll list them on the screen. But yeah, this, I had to go back and do Gore's face because I skipped over it by accident. I think that's like a lilac purple that I used for the mouth. And I did use the pencil again to go in and get those little small details. Add a little bit of shadow here and there. And pencil actually works surprisingly well with the color pencil and marker. So I did use that a lot, as you can see. And the drawing's really coming together. I used a medium blue here for his armor or shirt, whatever it is I'm gonna call it. And then I added another layer of color pencil on top of it. I could have probably went a bit darker, but you know, again, I have to try really hard to not get too focused on getting everything perfect, because you're just gonna end up putting in a lot more hours trying to get everything perfect. So I just try to come up with, you know, something in the vicinity, something that is at least looks like it. You know, I substitute different colors and I change different colors around, because you can't always get the exact look whenever you're sketching a drawing, and because it's just kind of frustrating. You can never get things 100%, but you can come close. So don't stress yourself out if you can't get every little detail perfect. And really don't try to, because it's not really worth it. So, but yeah, this drawing's coming to a close soon. I think I just have to do the cape, and that was pretty simple to do. That was one of the easiest parts of the drawing. But this was a fun piece to do. A lot of moving parts in this picture, though. It was difficult, I'd say, doing the hands, Gore's hands, and Thor's hammer. And I'm still kind of perplexed that the hammer was so difficult for me to do. It's just one of those things, you know, just one of those weird things that throws you off a little bit, but I ended up getting it, of course. I really did enjoy the story. Again, if you guys want to read about it, just definitely look up those two books. I'll probably link them in the description or something, and you know, check out the story for yourself. But overall, I'm pretty happy with how this came out. All the colors came together perfectly. I think it's, you know, not exact copy, but pretty close to the reference photo that I was looking at. So I'm definitely a big fan of the Marvel art that they have in the comics. And just the artist that did this, really, really talented. This last part, I just pretty much used marker to gray out the background, and it's probably my least favorite part. I don't really like doing backgrounds that much, but I tried my best. I tried my best, and I will, again, you know, not trying to do anything to get it perfect, just adding a few of the little details that I missed out here and there. But, you know, this is pretty much coming to a close. I really hope you guys enjoyed the drawing. Hopefully you learned something. And, you know, I'll probably be making a few more tutorials like this, just to give you guys a breakdown of how I like to approach my drawings. Whew. Yeah, that's pretty much it. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you in the next one.